Welcome, everybody. So, if you wanted to prove that you're not working for the Chinese government, what would be the best way to do that? I think that getting the Chinese government state media and Chinese government officials to leap to your defense certainly isn't the best way forward. But unfortunately, that's what's happened. Now, everybody, I would like you to, if you're not sure what's going on here, I'd like you to understand that I'm talking about Westerners who are parroting Chinese state communist propaganda and denigrating the West on YouTube and other free platforms out there. How's the audio? Audio's perfect. Good to hear. That sounds good. All right, fantastic. Thank you. We're just double checking that over here. Okay. Now, my video that I put out last week, in fact, I put out another one this week as well, was focusing on these YouTubers and foreign influencers who are basically just parroting Chinese media, Chinese state propaganda, and at the same time denigrating the West. And guess what happened? Well, I'm just going to show you a little clip, shall I? Let's get this up in the background and let's just play it for you. I'd like you to pay a little bit of attention.
Obviously, Beijing is not very savvy in pushing out his propaganda, I guess, for some people.
All right. Now, who has leapt to the defense of the CCP sycophants? Well, China's largest English language state media, and of course, communist government officials, which we'll get to shortly. But I think we need to know a little bit about what we're seeing in the background over here. What is CGTN? Well, CGTN, like I said, is China's largest English language state media. And if you look underneath their videos, when they do post on YouTube, you will see a little notation over there which says CGTN is funded in whole or in part by the Chinese government. So let's take a little bit another look. Let's look at the Wikipedia of CGTN, and there are a couple of notable things that we should talk about when it comes to CGTN over here. I am going to quickly bring up a couple of those notable things. We'll just make them a little bigger for you all to see on the screen. Right, let me get myself out of the picture. CGTN has been accused of propaganda and disinformation on behalf of the Chinese government and for airing forced confessions. We also have various other controversies that are linked to CGTN, such as the detained Australian journalist. In August of 2020, Australian CGTN television anchor Cheng Lei was detained by Chinese authorities on national security grounds, but no details of accusations were provided, and of course, she's still missing. On the 18th of September in 2019, Nick Pollard, a veteran British TV executive, resigned from his post as consultant and advisor to CGTN, giving his reasons for leaving as being CGTN's failure to comply with Ofcom's rules in impartiality in connection to its coverage of the Hong Kong anti-extradition bill protests. He had joined CGTN in December 2018. Ofcom had several inquiries into CGTN going on in September 2019. In a September 2019 article in The Diplomat, it stated that CGTN has consistent record of blatantly and egregiously violating journalistic standards and encouraging or justifying hatred and violence against innocent people. On the 17th of March 2020, CGTN aired a video in Arabic that Reporters Without Borders classified as disinformation related to the COVID-19 pandemic. Look, Chinese state media is not like the media in the West. Fox News, CNN, they have their agendas, they have all their nonsense, but Chinese state media is different, it's unified. It doesn't matter which branch of the media, it all follows a certain script. And that script is to push the agendas of the Chinese Communist Party. It is there specifically to push what the party wants to say, and it can never go against that. You have to understand. So for those of you out there who want to compare CGTN or CCTV or anything like that to other news outlets around the world like Al Jazeera or you know, whichever one you choose, BBC, it doesn't matter. They're not the same. And they're not the same for multiple reasons. Number one being that they can never, ever criticize the government of China. It's not possible. If you criticize the Chinese government and you're one of these news media outlets, whoever says it has to take responsibility and will be punished and dealt with and probably disappeared if it's high level. They are only there to defend the Chinese Communist Party. So it's kind of very, well, it's just incredibly interesting that this big state media outlet has now responded to this accusation that these YouTubers are working for the Chinese government. Well, obviously, because they're trying to defend their assets. We're going to look into that a little more. Let's continue on with this little clip here. Who is this host, by the way, this hostess, this pretty Chinese anchor that we see here? Well, anyone who knows anything about China will actually know who she is. Liu Xin is very famous. She's very bullish towards, or I should say aggressive towards the West. And she's incredibly patriotic, and she's very much on the side of the CCP, and she's a massive nationalist. And well, would it surprise you to know that there's actually a connection between Liu Xin and the Barretts? As you can see up there, the Barrett guy up there, the Lee and Ollie Barrett. Probably wouldn't surprise you, but let's take a look. There is actually a previous connection. Let's take a look at my friend Crime in China. Sorry, Prime in China.
Barrett trying to undermine American freedoms and democracy by agreeing with Liu Xin by direct messages on Twitter. Again, state-run media. I'm sure all of you here will remember Liu Xin, whom of course is very famous for having a debate with Trish Reagan on Fox News.
Okay, so it's very interesting that the Barretts have been messaging Liu Xin on Twitter and then suddenly appear on her show where she's defending them, saying that, you know, the Times, there was that article in the Times that basically said that these guys were getting paid to go around and do these fluff pieces and stuff. Now she's leaping to their defense. It's kind of interesting. You wouldn't expect a high-profile news anchor, political commentator, and sort of aggressive nationalist like Liu Xin to jump to the defense of anyone, unless, of course, she was defending them on behalf of the Chinese government. I mean, look at the kind of things that they're putting out there. Funded trips equals funded videos, question mark. See, they're trying to basically debunk the whole idea that these guys are spouting Chinese propaganda. That's the whole point of this defense. But the stupid thing is that by jumping to their defense, it actually proves that what they're doing is what the Chinese government wants. Right. Now, it's not only CGTN and Liu Xin who's jumped to the defense of these people, but plenty of other state media too. Let me get to it over here. I took a photo of my screen instead of a screenshot. Give me a second. There we go. China Plus News, which is a verified checkmark on Twitter, of course. And as you can see below the name, it says China State Affiliated Media. They jumped to the defense of these guys too and said the British newspaper The Times lie about British YouTubers being funded by hashtag China, got debunked by the YouTubers themselves. And then it links to the guy's response videos. Now that's kind of like saying that convicted serial killer debunked the fact that he's a serial killer. He said he's not, so we just have to believe him. You know, it's ridiculous. So Chinese state-affiliated media, not only the biggest English language one, which is CGTN, but now other smaller ones like China Plus News are jumping to their defense too. So we're seeing a lot of different branches of state media because now it's their narrative, and we're going to see it from various different news outlets because once one runs with a story, the others have to disseminate and they have to follow this line. They're jumping out to defend these guys saying, oh, no, the Chinese government doesn't pay these guys. These guys, you know, et cetera, et cetera. It's kind of ridiculous. But then it gets even more ridiculous because the Global Times, which if you don't know what the Global Times is, it's the official Communist Party English language newspaper that puts out these ridiculous opinion pieces and so on, but it's completely condoned by the Communist Party of China. They also put out an article, "Why the Times does not want readers to see true life in China." Now, they're not talking about the Global Times, they're talking about the Times. Of course, the article that was originally released in the Times, basically calling out British YouTubers being funded to help fight China's propaganda war. This is their response to them. Now, I'm not going to bore you with this whole article, but basically what it says here is, on several of China's video sharing apps, some Chinese vloggers living or studying in Western countries also make videos to share their experiences. Many of them praise Western lifestyle and manners, which deserve our learning. However, I have not heard any Chinese media outlet label them as funded by Western countries to produce pro-West propaganda. Well, that's a bunch of bullshit. Because if a Chinese citizen living overseas starts making videos in America and parroting American talking points and says that Trump's trade war is a good thing, or anything about whatever the government does is a good thing, that's of course not something that China agrees with, they will immediately be labeled by the netizens and everyone else as a CIA spy or as a traitor to China. And prove me wrong, you can't, because I know people who have spoken out against certain things like human rights atrocities, or spoken out against the fact that there's lack of freedom of speech, actual Chinese people living abroad, and they get crucified. Just look at that poor girl who made a speech about freedom when she was reading her sort of college speech. You all know the story. She got crucified and had to come and make a public apology. When Chinese people in the West put out social media that praises Western governments or says anything bad about the Chinese government, they are destroyed. But in this kind of context where you've got Westerners in China who are talking absolute crap about their own governments and Western democracy and stuff, tearing that down, and at the same time trying to push forward and lift up the message of the Chinese Communist Party, they are defended by the Chinese state media, and Chinese government officials. It's very fishy, isn't it? Let's read a little more here about this article. It says, Western elites are reluctant to see China's progress as they cannot accept a country whose political system and path it follows are completely different from the West to receive such a remarkable achievement. This is a very tired old nationalist, especially the 50 Cent Army line. It's all about, oh, the West doesn't want to say anything positive about China because China's so great now and the West can't accept that China's done so well. It's not the case. We're dealing with Westerners who are just parroting, you know, and they've been linked to the government through their funded trips and their fluff pieces, but they're parroting the talking points. They are doing things like saying that the Xinjiang concentration camps are a good thing, right? They're parroting some really bad shit. They are parroting the narrative and at the same time constantly attacking the West and saying that the democracy of the West is bad and how bad the West has handled certain things because democracy is at fault or the system's at fault. But look at how good and how well China handles these things. You know, these guys are doing, and they're walking a fine line here. They're talking a lot of nonsense here. But I think the funniest part of all of this is that what they end up saying, the gist of it, which we'll see in some other things. And by the way, this article confirms what Barrett said about the Xinjiang camps being a good thing in this article. Great job. What you'll see is they're trying to push this narrative that unless you don't live in China, or you haven't lived in China, or you're not on the ground in China, you don't know what's going on, right? And so they're trying to say you have to trust what these foreigners are saying. And the reason why they're saying that is because these foreigners are doing exactly what they want. These Westerners that they have there on YouTube are doing what they want, saying what they want, which is the Chinese government line, the party line. That's what they're saying. And they're saying bad things about the West, which is what they want. But here's another thing. The Barretts, they put out like a little facetious little tweet to the Times to say, huh, thanks guys, haha, you gave us so much, you gave us such a spotlight, we gained a bunch of subscribers, in your face type thing. And Ma Hui, which we'll talk about in a minute, is a Chinese government official, said, you are doing a great job telling what China is. Many have never visited China but seemed to be experts on China. Let me tell you something, Ma Hui and Barretts. I lived in China for 14 years. I'm the first YouTuber to ever make videos about China. I've explored China extensively on my motorcycle and through documentaries and various other things. I have seen China and I've experienced China. I can speak Chinese and I can read the language. So, Ma Hui, I know China. If you want to say like many have never visited China but are seen to be experts, I have visited China. I lived in China. I have Chinese family. I have Chinese friends. I'm married to a Chinese woman. I have a half Chinese daughter. All right. So I can tell you right now that what the Barretts are putting out there is a bunch of bollocks and it's only what you want to hear. It's the state-sponsored propaganda nonsense because they don't understand Chinese. They read the news from places like the Global Times or from international newspapers or the things like the Shenzhen Daily or whatever else where it's written in English. That's how they get their news. And of course, all news coming out of the state in China is positive about China and negative about the West. So it shapes their views. And they can walk around and have opinions about stuff and that's totally fine. But the stuff that they're putting out, the politically charged things they put out on their channels, it's just Chinese propaganda. Anyway, who is Ma Hui? Let's find out. Ma Hui is the minister of the Chinese embassy in the UK. So there it is in London, Great Britain. So we have here a Chinese government official who works in the Chinese embassy in the UK, basically saying that these guys are telling the truth and, you know, anyone who doesn't agree with them is a liar. And this is a Chinese government official of the Communist Party endorsing what they do. So what the hell, guys? You're not working for the government. You're not doing government propaganda. Why is the government backing you up, defending you, putting you on state media? Why? It's very simple. It's because you are doing exactly what they want. You are parroting their propaganda. Okay, let's move on a little bit because there's something else we have to really talk about. Probably the elephant in the room, shouldn't we? YouTube. What you're watching right now is blocked in China. Not only is it blocked, but it's forbidden. You're not allowed to go and see YouTube if you're Chinese. That's why it's blocked. The Great Firewall of China, also known as the Golden Shield Project, was put in place to prevent Chinese people from accessing the free world. Websites like Facebook, Twitter, YouTube are blocked. They're blocked for a reason. That's because Chinese citizens are not supposed to see them. The government has deemed those websites too sensitive. And in their minds, those websites put out too much misinformation, the kind of thing that could alter somebody's mind living in China and maybe make them think a little differently. Because on those websites, you do find people who criticize the Chinese government in one form or the other, or at least criticize their policies or say things that they don't like, or the narratives that they put out to the public are sometimes challenged. And this is something that they don't accept. Right? So it's blocked. In fact, using a VPN in China is illegal. People have been arrested for selling VPNs in China. People have been arrested for using VPNs in China. People have been arrested for posting things on Western social media in China, where they're not supposed to. So my question to you is this. Let's go back just a smidge here. Just a little smidge. Oh, there's a particular thing I want to show you. Because in the thumbnail of this particular video that they put out, plain as day, YouTube. The Chinese state media is leaping to the defense of people that are breaking the law within the borders of China. Now, why would they do such a thing? You're not allowed to be a YouTuber in China. YouTube is a blocked and forbidden website. Why are they defending people that are breaking the law? It's very simple. It's because you're either government or you're little people. The government doesn't need to pay attention to the laws of China. That's why you have CGTN, CCTV, and a myriad of other state medias on places like YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and all of that kind of thing. Because the average Chinese person is not allowed to do that. I can't stress this enough. that what they're doing is defending something that's illegal within their own borders and talking to people that are within their own borders doing something illegally. I mean, bam, doesn't that just clear things up here? The fact that they condone illegal activity like this means it's what they want. I mean, think about it. If you're in a country doing something illegal, like selling drugs or something that's totally illegal, right? And you get called onto a talk show or something, and they're like, oh, some people say you're a bad person. You're selling drugs, but they say your quality of your drugs is bad, but we know your quality of your drugs is good. That's kind of what's going on here, guys. They are defending illegal activities within their borders. So, does that not prove that these guys are doing the bidding of the Chinese Communist Party? I think it sure as hell does. So we've got them in all these different, state media and all that kind of thing. But I would like you guys to watch what happened during this little live stream, because it's kind of interesting and it's kind of funny. And well, let's take a look.
Reply. Exactly what happened? I don't hear you. Opinions. What happened? All right, we're not able to hear you. I'm sorry, Lee, we're not able to hear you somehow. About request for your opinion, did you respond? Well, unfortunately, because of technical issues, we can't get the audios out for whatever reason. We do this every week, but somehow this week it just doesn't work. Much apologies. I'm really sorry. I don't know what happened. Obviously, Beijing is not very savvy in pushing out its propaganda, I guess, for some people.
Okay. So, how is it possible that China's largest English language state media apparatus does not know how to run a live stream? I mean, sure, I'm just a pikey little YouTuber here. I have technical difficulties in that, but I still managed to get the audio out like I am right now, right? Guys, this is a joke. You're going to see more and more pieces coming out in the Chinese media defending these guys. And the more pieces that come out defending them, the more it proves that they are working for the Chinese government. And whether or not they're being paid or not, they're certainly doing exactly what the Chinese government wants them to do. And that is to spread the positive propaganda and fluff pieces about China. Oh, look at the amazing infrastructure. Look how well everything's worked out. We dealt with COVID so well. Look how we lifted everyone out of poverty. Look at our high-speed rails. Wow, China's amazing. Look at these beautiful cities with all these lights. That kind of stuff is boring. That's something that everybody already knows. It's not a secret. We all know that China has achieved a lot. There's nothing wrong with what China's achieved at all. In fact, a lot of it's very impressive. The problem is that these guys are completely unbalanced and they're just 100% in it for basically sucking the jiba of the CCP. I don't know how else to say it. You know, brown-nosing the Communist Party, while at the same time on their channels constantly ragging on the West. So they have an agenda, and this agenda is being rewarded. They're like little stooges, you know? They're people that are doing the bidding of the Chinese Communist Party, and so they are rewarded. And they are rewarded with, you know, things like views. They're rewarded with spotlights on state media. They're rewarded with spotlights and defense by the Chinese government through all their state-sponsored media and, of course, all their government officials and stuff tweeting at them and so on. And it's not just a couple. There are a lot more. I could have dug out a whole lot more. I'm just not out here to do that. It just boils my blood. This obviously was not going to be my video for this week. As you can see, it's a live that's just come up because this live stream thing only happened last night. So I really had to just say something about it because these guys are digging themselves a deeper hole. I do have something that I wanted to say. Let me just write, let's see, I've got to get my little thing up here. Yes, this is what I'd like to say. This is what I'd like to say to those YouTubers who are being defended by Chinese Communist state media and by the government officials. Thank you. Thank you for exposing the inner workings. of how China's ham-fisted attempt to twist the narrative through our Western social media. You are exposing it very cleanly and very clearly. China, these guys are actually doing the opposite of what you want. If you're a CCP official out there, I'd like you to take note. The more you push these guys, the more we can see exactly how you work. So your so-called subtle attempts to influence people through YouTube, using loopholes, through free social media, freedom of speech, and so on, it's now being laid bare. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. So thank you to you guys for being such narcissistic twats that you want to go out there and try and keep pushing this narrative, because guess what you've done? Is you've exposed the inner workings of how the CCP tries to influence everyone. I just had to say that. You know, China is using our systems of free speech against us. They're taking over our social media through dirty and underhanded tactics. And this is going to be a focus of mine for some time. Obviously, I'm going to be putting other things out there. But specifically in our upcoming podcast, like I said, this is just the tip of the iceberg. And we're preparing something very big for Thursday's podcast next week. And I really do want every single one of you guys to tune in for that, because this is, as you can see, very last minute with very, very little to no preparation, I should say. I also have another kind of question. You know, since I left China and C-Milk left China, a couple of other people, why is it that we don't see a balanced view coming out of China from any of these so-called YouTubers? Why? The only thing you see right now is positive fluff piece nonsense about how great China is, or look at how great the Chinese food is. And that's fine. If you're going to be a food blogger or a travel blogger or whatever, that's totally fine. The thing that separates these guys from somebody who's just doing positive travel videos and food blogs or whatever it is that these guys get political. And they praise the Communist Party while denigrating the West on their channels. But why is it that you don't get anyone being neutral and pointing out some of the actual issues that China does have? It doesn't exist anymore. So now that job has fallen squarely on the shoulders of people like myself and C-Milk, and there are others out there. We are up against, as you can see, the entire Chinese government machine. They are out to suppress channels like mine and C-Milk's and others. And the reason they want to do that is because we are seen as an enemy, because the biggest enemy of the CCP is the truth. Other channels that just parrot whatever the Chinese Communist Party wants to say, they're being boosted and bolstered. And we're going to see them appearing everywhere. So if you start to see positive CCP stuff popping up in your feed, wherever you are, you have to know that there's a reason for this. Powerful, very rich, government-backed state media is behind them. Clearly so. Here they are being defended on the largest state media, English state media. CGTN, by the way, is CCTV. They changed the name to try and distance themselves, because CCTV has a kind of a negative connotation to it. A lot of people don't realize this, but it is just CCTV, just the English kind of branch of it. And that's pretty much all I have to say on the subject. Let me just check my notes to make sure I didn't miss anything important here. Let's see. I do have a little warning to these guys. You have to understand that you may think you're protected right now, but the problem is the more and more you do this, the more proof you're giving the West. Not only journalists, but citizens of the West, of how twisted the Chinese government is when it comes to influencing social media. And one of these days, you're going to wake up on the wrong side of the fence. You're not going to be the people they want to defend. You'll be the people they want to demonize. I went through the same myself. When I first started my videos about China, of course, especially during the honeymoon phase, I was incredibly positive. I had nothing bad to say about China, because there are a lot of positive things to say about China. It is a wonderful place. There's a lot of good as well as a lot of bad. But while I was putting out my fluff pieces and all my positive stuff, I grew very big on Chinese social media. I was also invited onto TV shows and things like that. I was been in newspapers and all that kind of thing. I was, seen in a very positive light, and they were pushing me all over the place, like trying to make me more popular. But I tell you what, As soon as I started to become a little bit more realistic and started to speak about some of the uncomfortable truths around me, boy, did that change. The same people that were trying to lift me up and try to put me out there are the same people that attacked my wife and my family back home, tried to bring them down, tried to get me imprisoned, tried to get me deported, tried to get me jailed as a spy, tried to get my wife disciplined and get her make her lose her job, tried to get her detained as a spy or a foreign sympathizer, tried to get harassment and attacks against my family back in South Africa. These are the same people. So just remember, this is just a caution to you guys, is that when you fall out of favor, things aren't going to go your way. And you have to be realistic about it. That's it. I've spoken enough on this subject. Everyone, I'm going to take a look to see if there have been any super chats here. And I will see if I can briefly answer some of them. But I'm trying to save it for our podcast because we are going to have a big one all about this. So let's take a look. We have a couple of super chats. I'm just going to rip through them very quickly. Thank you to everybody who's put in a super chat here. I'm going to save all your questions, which we will answer in depth on our podcast. I'm just saving them right now. But in the meantime, let's see. Thank you from, I don't know how to pronounce that, something upstate. Here's $5 from the US CIA, which we all know pays people to make videos to make China look bad. Absolutely, thank you. I'm not going to read that out. It says, recently a Chinese game streamer starved to death and amid Xi's propaganda campaign that says China has eliminated poverty. I mean, come on, look. Propaganda from any country is usually... they over-exaggerate, and it's not true. It's just not true. The problem is, in China, you can't call them out. So in a country like America, if the government goes out to say, we've completely lifted people out of poverty, you'll have a million people out there saying, screw you, look at the homeless people on the street, you're lying. But in China, you can't do that. You can't say to the government, screw you, you're lying, there's people starving here or people that are homeless. They'll shut you up and take you away. Okay. Let's see. Like I said, guys, I've spoken enough on this. I'm going to take each one of your super chats right here. I'm going to save them for Thursday's podcast. I will answer them, and I appreciate your support greatly. Like I said before, I'm up against the Chinese government at the moment and the Chinese nationalist 50 Cent Army. They are actively trying to suppress my channel. They're actively trying to take me down. They have been doing this for years, but their efforts have redoubled recently, especially in light of all this nonsense that's come out. So your support, however little it may be, even you just watching this video, means a hell of a lot to me. So I will not lose any of these questions, and they will be answered in the podcast on Thursday. If you're not aware, we do a podcast every Thursday now, ADV Podcasts. I'll put a link in the description when I'm done with this. We discuss all these kind of things like soft power. We discuss how the Chinese government operates. We look at things in the news when it comes to China. We're very up to date with people that we know in China. And of course, the Chinese news sources themselves. Since we can read Chinese, we get it straight from the Chinese media. And we know how to interpret it correctly. So that's really it, guys. I just wanted to say once again that shame on these guys for basically proving me right. To be on Liu Xin's show, my word, it really doesn't get any more ridiculous than that. I'm going to leave you again with something that Liu Xin said, and then we're going to finish this up, guys. And thank you, absolutely, everyone out there, stay awesome.
Week, it just doesn't work. Much apologies. I'm really sorry. I don't know what happened. Obviously, Beijing is not very savvy in pushing out its propaganda, I guess, for some people.